Amp forms is the most difficult amp techniques to master. It took me a couple weeks to get it right. So if you need to do backend validation, you also need to include the amp mustache component, which is a template engine that amp uses to display validation errors on forms or success messages. If you don't want to do any custom backend validation, then you don't need this component. You need to include the amp form component, but unlike other amp components, you just use the ordinary HTML tag. No need to prefix it with amp. Now, amp has a lot of different attributes, and they are mandatory based on whether you're submitting the amp via the post or the get method. All right, so let's code a simple form. It is easier to create get forms in amp than this post forms, and I'll show you why in a minute. So we're using the ordinary HTML form tag. Now let's do method get, and then let's do action, for example, some script.php. All right. Then if you're having a form that is using the get method, you need to add the target attribute. Now what the target attribute does is, if you're having the form submit via get, you need to tell the server or amp how you're going to process the success or the error messages. So if you're processing the success messages at the top of the page, then this value of target must be underscore top, all right? But if you're processing the error messages on a new page, for example, if you're redirecting after successful submission, saying thank you for contacting us, we'll be in touch as soon as possible in a new page, then it must be, the value must be blank, all right? Let me give you a quick example. So this is an example of PHP code I wrote on successful form submission. So I had a site, and the site wanted to have a contact form. So I made it so that whenever the contact form gets processed and the email sent from it, the page will get reloaded, and at the top of the page, this message will appear, all right? So since I added it on the top of the page, in the target attribute, I added the value of top, all right? But if I wanted to display this message in a new page, then I should have added the value of blank, all right? Now this is, the target attribute is mandatory if you're using get. If you're using post, then you can skip the target attribute. Since with post, we are doing all the requests asynchronously. So you're gonna have all the messages or the errors on the same page. All right. So we have here a valid amp form using the method get. And it's very straightforward. You don't need any other fancy attributes. The only thing you need to do is, on your processing script, whether it's JavaScript, PHP, or SAP, you need to enable core security, all right? But other than that, get, very straightforward. It's the easiest amp form to do. Now, when it gets complicated is when you want to process post forms. Let me show you an example. So first off, instead of adding action, which is going to be the file of the script that's going to process the form, it needs to be action dash XHR, which stands for XML HTTP request. And what that means is, whenever the user submits the form, instead of reloading the page, it's going to process it beneath the scenes or behind the scenes, and then we're going to get either a error message or a success one. All right, so then we do, for example, script.php whenever the file is located on our server. The other attribute that is mandatory is the method, which is post. And then we need a way to display to the user the error messages or the success message. And for that, we're going to use amp mustache. Now, I'm going to quickly show you the form I have written for the fur baby landing page. Let me just paste it on the screen real quick. All right, let's go through those lines one by one. First, we have action XHR, which will show where our file that needs to process the form is located. Then the second one is verify-XHR. Now, what this is going to do is, this is going to conduct the verification process, which we're going to talk about later. But basically, this is where your verification and data validation is going to rest or stay. For example, if you need all the input fields inputted, if you need them filled in, then you're going to have to check it with this attribute, and this attribute value contains the script where our validation is. And you can have it on the same file as your submission script, and this is what I did, okay? Then we have method post, we have a class, which is normal, and then we have the custom validation reporting. Now, what this is going to do is, this is going to define how you report errors. So you can have show all and submit, or show as you go. There are different different types. So I usually do show all and submit. So for example, if user needs to fill in all the input fields and they just press submit without filling any of them in, instead of saying, okay, you need to populate your email, it will say you need to populate your email, you need to populate your message, you need to populate your name, all right? Okay. Then we have field set, just the URL and the HTML, run-of-the-mill form, there's nothing different with AMP. This is where it gets very interesting. This is the AMP mustache that is going to validate our form, okay? So we have here verify-error. Now, this is going to show up if the user makes a mistake and our verification process catches it. So if the user makes a mistake, we're going to add all the errors in an array, and then we're going to output them with amp-mustache, which is our template engine, all right? Submit error is going to be if the submission has an error, okay? So for example, if you misspell the file of your script, or the internet suddenly stops working, then they're going to get this error. And then we have submit success, which is going to submit or going to show whenever the submission is correct. And by correct submission, we mean if the user returns a response of 200 or just any, the ballpark of 200. And submit verify error is going to show if the server returns a response of 400. Both get and post require course enabled on the server, so make sure you have that. Then we have the amp mustache for displaying the errors or the successes. And post is always, always asynchronous, which means that when the user presses the submit button, it's not going to reload the page. So that's what makes it very difficult. While get is always unasynchronous, it's going to reload the page just like your normal form.